In today's Morning Meds, we'll answer the question, what do Christians believe? So if you're ready, then let's go. Good morning and welcome back to Morning Meds, where we meditate on God's word in order to tackle everyday issues that we face as Christians. And if you like Morning Meds, be sure to like, share, and subscribe so that we can make it through this life together with the help of God. It is very possible to believe in God and not be a Christian. So how do you know when to identify yourself as a Christian and when not to? To solidify our identity in Christ, we'll discuss the five foundational beliefs of Christianity, starting with the Trinity. As Christians, we believe that God is God in three ways, and not one third of each, but fully each. We believe He's fully God, fully Jesus, and equally the Holy Spirit. This is only possible because God is not a person as we've trained ourselves to believe. God is a spirit. The only human representation that we have of God is Jesus during His time on earth, which leads us right into our second foundational belief that Jesus is fully God. We know that Jesus spent time on earth, 33 years to be exact, but the Christian belief is that Jesus is fully God, that He was in the beginning with God. John 1:1 says that He is the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So even before time began, Jesus is present. His human body is not present, but Jesus, as who He is, as the full God that He is present. He is there before Genesis 1:1. Our next foundational belief is the faith in our salvation through Jesus Christ. We believe that Jesus's life and death was necessary in order to free us from the law that the Jewish custom and religion still follow today. Jesus came to end our dependence on rules and regulations alone and helped us build an independent relationship between us and God. This means that we no longer need priests or rabbis to go to God for us. We now have an open communication with God because of Jesus' sacrifice and resurrection. Next, as Christians, we believe that the Bible is God's holy word. The Bible to a Christian is like an instruction manual to a new appliance. It gives us the steps that we need to take in order to live a life that's pleasing to God. The Word of God is active, and it touches the very heart of a person. If you are a Christian and you're not reading the Word of God, chances are you're malfunctioning and you don't even know it. We find in 2 Timothy chapter 3 that the Word of God and Scripture is useful so that the servant of God will be thoroughly equipped for every good work. And finally, we believe that there is life after death. As Christians, we believe that Jesus Christ is on His way back from heaven to make His kingdom here on earth and to judge the world. Those who have trusted Jesus for their salvation will be eternally with the Father. But those who choose any way other than Jesus Christ will be eternally separated from the presence of God. The only way to apply this information to our lives is to check our beliefs. The Lord gives us free will, so we all must make the choice. We cannot choose for anyone but ourselves what we believe. And once we've decided what we believe, we must be sure and allow the Word of God to take root in our hearts so that no one can shake us to the right or to the left. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day, and we thank you, God, for our beliefs. We thank you, God, for our foundation. Lord, we ask you, Lord, to forgive us for the wrong that we've done, said, and thought. We ask you, Lord God, to forgive us for doubt, any doubt that we feel. We ask you, Lord, to help us grow in knowledge so that we can have faith in who you are, faith in your salvation, faith in your Son, Jesus Christ, and faith in your triune deity. We love you, God. We bless your name. You're so great and greatly to be praised. No matter what we decide, God, the word of God says that every knee will bow and every knee will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So we honor you, God. We honor you and we honor the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for your Holy Spirit, who is our comforter and guide. Thank you for all that you've done. Bless every household represented. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.